or you want to do the way Amazonas, this one. It's up to you, which one you want. You want to do which one you want. You want a wave and resonance, or you want a mechanical oscillation. But for each of those one, if you pick, you need to do three experiments, okay? Each of those one, they have three sub-experiments. I call those ones sub-experiments. Experiments one, experiments two, and experiments three. You need to do all of those three experiments because each of those one, they look at different parameters can affect the oscillation, okay? Now, before I start, please make that correction because this one is introduction. If you look at the introduction, all of those things you are doing today and you need to do some analysis, be dealing with the equation like that one, exponential equation, and you need to take the log, and also you are plotting the log graph. Okay, make this correction, please. This one is, should be n instead of a, and that one should be log r. There is a type. Usually we have some of those type, but you should not worry about that. Okay, now, background information is here. If you want to go with the mechanical oscillation, we have a bifilar pendulum. And setup of experiments, experiments detail is here. And setup of experiments. Remember in first experiments, you use all those things to attach the string. Now, we're using all those ones. I think usually we have 10 sets or maybe 12, I'm not sure. If you're running of those one is B, you need to go with the mechanical oscillation. Oh, you have to use all those chalk pins. Chalk, look at that. Just let me to see, you do that with this one before, yeah. Look, you use all that pin chalk. If there is no any pin chalk left, it means you need to go to the wave and resonance because we don't have enough of that one. Okay, you have that pin chalk. You need two of those one. We put a string inside it, take the long length of a string because when you want to change that S, you have to just bring it up the string from here and adjust the length, okay, for the string. Now, what you want to have a look at that, first experiments here, experiments one, effect of a string separation on period of oscillation. Okay, it means this is a separation is called D, you want to change the D, therefore S and the length of the aluminum rod should be constant, you are not changing. You are changing only one variable. It means every time you have a one variable, not two variables. Okay, you're changing the D, and after that you wanted to see, when you're changing the D, how that one can affect the period of oscillation. Again, there is a typo here. Please make that correction, and instead of the B, this one should be D, because as you can see, it's a D. Okay, therefore the formula is a T, A, D to power of A. Okay, in each experiment, when you're doing the experiments, you're dealing with the exponential equation, and after that, it's asking you find that power n, find that constant a. And also, please, before packing your equipment, have a look. There are some questions here asking you, for example, here, do predict. We are doing the prediction, yes, this one is from your graph, but you need to do experimentally as well. For example, you need to find experimentally when a string separation is 42.5 centimeter, how much is the oscillation? You can answer those questions in the part of the analysis. Okay, let me to explain that one. Just I want to bring the one. Is measure measure the period? Period is a time for one complete oscillation. Okay, what is the one complete oscillation? Even here, maybe I should show you because I want you to read this slide manual. Okay. Otherwise, I can make that from PowerPoint, say do that, do that, do that. Well, usually I stick to the lab manual because sometimes I explain very quickly. Sometimes maybe you cannot hear me clearly. Sometimes maybe you forgot what I say. But when you know from where I found those information, you can back to your lab manual and see those information again. Here you can see it's mentioned, make an angle about 5 degrees. Look, is it about 5 degrees? When you want to make an oscillation, this is your aluminum rope. You are attaching two strings to that one. Yes, it's standing like that. You want to make an oscillation, to make the oscillation. Yes, it's telling you 5 degrees. 5 degrees is something about that. You should not worry, oh, is it 5 degrees or not. Yes, you cannot do it like this. Okay? Or you cannot do it like that, otherwise it's not going to oscillate. And also when you have a string, you can see you are not able to tilt it too much. In some way, it resists to tilt it. Okay. When you catch it 5 degrees, it's me. I tilted that one like 5 degrees, and after that, let this one to oscillate. And you want to make it the period. There is a time for one complete oscillation, okay? If I can give my start point is from here, if the start point from here, come back, this is the one complete oscillation. Or if I just bring it to this side, this is the start, go back, this is the one complete oscillation, and I made it in time for that one. You don't need to measure 5 times, 4 times. This is when you measure it just only once, okay? And it should be oscillated like that one, in that way, okay? If it go like this one, like the string is around, it should not go forward and backward, like a string. It should be oscillated like this, okay? It's a hard to measure, I know, but definitely you will figure out. Okay, this is the for oscillation, now you know what to do. Okay, let me explain those one quickly. Where is one thing? This one. Okay. Now, second part of experiments is you changing experimentally, changing the length of S is mean you changing that. Okay, how many changes you need? You need at least 4. Even 4D. Remember, we need at least 4 data points to be able to plot the graph. Okay. At least 4 of that one, 4 of D. And again, before you packing your equipment, you have to measure when you experimentally, when the length is 150 centimeter, what is the period, okay? Just be careful about those questions because usually students hacking everything and after that they recognize, oops, I didn't measure those one. And they have to back again, do all of those setup. Please, before packing, make sure you doing those one experimentally. I explained that one. And last part is changing of the aluminum rod size. I'll show you we have a different size over there. You can pick at least 4 of those one and do the experiments. And now we have a one aluminum rod is 55 centimeter. On that time, if you cannot find, you can just scream and ask the other people who has 55 centimeter. Okay, I'm joking. You can just tell me. You cannot find, tell me. Definitely, I will scream for you. Now, this is for this experiment. If you want to do the weight and resonance, This is the setup of your experiments. Just for that setup, we have an actuator, and that one, instead of to be set up like that one, it will attach here. Okay, this one will attach here. It's coming to sitting here. Not like that. It's sitting here. And after that, we are doing the connection. Okay, put your mask, please. No, not that side. Not that side. My lady, will you please back to this side? Because the other side
is going
to
be
this side. No, no, you cannot do it on that table. You should sit on that table.
You're wanting off.
Because they put those microscope over there, we cannot do, we cannot do any setting over there. This is the reason. Do you have a mask? If not, you have to go to the building one, security, and take one of those. Okay, guys. Now, we have to attach this one. No, you cannot stay in the lab. You have to go. No, no, you cannot stay without the mask. Let's go building one, security. Or maybe you find some of those guys, they call Marshall. Maybe they have some spare. Okay. Now, at any time, guys, if you forgot, oh, where is your mask? Where is your mask? Oh, okay, put it, please. Anytime if you forgot to bring your mask, that's okay. You can go to building one. Oh, where is yours? Could you please put the water bottle in the bag? I'm talking with you. Sir, I didn't want to point it out, but the cereal bottle is on top of the table. And also, anytime when you want to drink the bottle, you can go outside, not inside the lab. Variation of the frequency with a string length. You changing the string length is mean from here to top of here. This is the length. You change the string length. This is the variable. And also, again, you have some experimental measurements. And last part is a variation of the frequency with mass per unit of the length. Mass per unit of the length we call mu, and it's a mass per L. Okay, you can pick some specific length, it's up to you. Is length can be 1 meter, any meters, you know. And after that, measure the mass. It's giving you the mu, and you can go with that formula. Okay, I'm doing one of those ones from each of those experiments about the calculation and analysis, what you wanted to do. And after that, you can collect your data. And also, you need to do for the all of those three experiments the same. Okay. First thing, I just picked one of those from law firm here. When you want to do the data analysis, and also in data analysis, you're putting the table, and also you're putting the graph, plus any question like this one, you can answer in data analysis. Okay, it's telling you find N, find A, and also plot a suitable graph. Okay, which kind of the graph you want to plot? You want to plot it only because we want to have a linear graph, we have to plot the log graph. For this is your equation, a d to the power of n. I want to find what is the n. I want to find what is the a. Looks, because you did the crater experiments, is similar to that one when you want to deal with those equations. Remember you had the exponential equation for the crater as well, and also you plot the log graph over there as well. Okay, to take this one, the first thing is to take the log. Log t equal n log d plus log a. If I write in the linear, the equation of the linear line is a y equal mx plus b. Therefore, in y direction, I have to put log t. In x direction, I have to put the log d. Therefore, a slope or gradient of the line is a value of n. N is a slope. And what else? I want to find the a. Intercept is log a. Is mean log a equal intercept. But the question asking you find a. You want to find a. Therefore, you have to take the log inverse. Is mean log inverse of the b equal a. Or in fact, your a is 10 to the power of the b, because the, all of those one is the base 10. Log base 10. Okay, you plotting it exactly this graph. Log t should be here. And you have a log d here. Remember, maybe is going down, I don't know, maybe it's going up. But definitely you have a linear line. Okay. Another things, you need a table before plotting the graph. Before plotting the graph, when you're doing the experiments, you have a D. Make sure that D should be in meter. Even if you want to put in centimeter, you can write it down times 10 minus 2 and put in the centimeter. Another things you want, when you just changing the D, you're measuring the period. Period is a S. You need at least 4 value. And therefore, you have a 4 value here because you're plotting the log T versus the log D. Therefore, you wanted to know log D as well, and you wanted to know log T. Don't worry about the calculation of uncertainty here because you're measuring once and that's it. Okay, at least today you are not doing the calculation for error, and you don't need to add the error bar. this is for your girl. Make sure also when he's asking you credit, when you have an equation of your line like this one, you can put the value for D. For example, if D is a 42.5 centimeter, convert that one to the meter, take the log D, sub your equation, you will find the log T. After that, take the log inverse to find what is the period, for example, for that 42.5. This is the base of your equation. You can find from interpolation from your graph. For example, if my graph is like that, if I know log D, for example, if a D is a 42.5 centimeter, is mean 42.5 times 10 minus 2 meter, I take the log of that D, say this is here, and after that I should go up, have a cross, and go there. This is a log T related to that point. When you want a T, you have to take the log inverse of that. Okay, log inverse of your value. This is a base of the interpolation, but because now you have your equation in Excel, and with all of those details, even of intercept, is much easier to solve in the formula. Okay, this is the one example from the first one. I'm doing the same one example from wave and resonance. I do there for the first one. Look, therefore this is a four, because last time the students tell me, oh, now when I have a S, what should I do for S? I said, okay. Therefore, if your table in a study, you need to put S. When you're changing the route, it means you have a three tables and you have a three graphs. Make a sense? Okay. Maybe sometimes we see, we assume this one is a clear for plot. I say this is only for experiments one. This is experiments one. You have to do for experiments two. You have to do for experiments three, okay? Sometimes I assume is it clear, but it looks like it's not clear. Now, I'm doing for the one of those one from wave and resonance, the same frequency. Frequency is A, and that one is the tension, T, to the what we show as a tau. Tau to power of the B. Okay, again, you're changing the tension. You're changing the tension. Maybe you want to write the mass if you want. If you want, it depends on you. You can write it on the mass, should be in kilogram, and after that, tension equal mg. And the unit is a newton. You need to take the log, and also when you're changing the tension, you have a frequency. Unit is a hertz. You need to take the log T. You need to have the log of the frequency. Look, those one you needed to do it. Okay, again I'm doing the same, log F equal B, log of the tension, plus log A. Y equal Fx plus B. Therefore, in Y direction, I have to put the log F. In X direction, I have to put the log of tension. Anything given to me, for example, if it's go up like that, I don't know, maybe it's go down. Look, I'm just giving you an example. If it's go up like that one, if it's go like that, that one down. A slope. Therefore, a slope equal B here. B equal M equal a slope. But the thing is here, by chance, I call that one B dash. Intercept. Because I have a B, I have a B. I don't want to mix both of those ones. One of those one is the base of the slope. You can find this one is the base of the intercept. Okay. Therefore, intercept log A. Log A equal intercept of 1A is mean log inverse of the intercept for 10 to power of B dash. Okay, look, this the same, we are doing the same. For example, if you have this one, mass per unit of the length, you have table. If you want, you can put directly mu is a mass per unit of the length. the mask. You want to put the air, and after that you want to put the new. Look, it's up to you. You can put directly what is the new. And after that, for each of those new, you have frequency. Again, you will need to, because I'm not sure how many strings we have in here. It's depend of the different type of string you have in here. If you have a four, you go with four. If you have only three, you need to put the three. And definitely you want a log mu, and you want a log F as well. Okay, make sense? And again, when I want to pull out, definitely I pull out the log of F versus the log of the mu. Look, all of those ones is similar to each other, just only those parameters will change. But the way, the format is exactly the same. I leave all of those on here. You can come anytime to pick it or take the photo from here or complete your notes. And that's it. Okay.
If you want to go, you need to take that one, which one is bạn đừng bạn đừng ổn vậy. Các bạn á. Dạ thì ba đưa mẫu. Dạ. Thôi cứ như cũ.
Như vậy thôi. Sure, we have a scale over there, you can measure.